except for this one thing, there seemed to have been a lot of musicians with him. Because I mean, there wasn't just yourself, I mean, Steve Grogan played the guitar and sang, because Manson himself was a musician, but I mean, I heard that one of the girls played the horn and things.
Played what?
The horn.
No, there was a guy who played a horn. Hmm. He just, you know, he had, I guess, had a few French horn lessons when he was in school or something, and he played a couple of times. Mm-hmm. You know, it didn't really quite fit with what Charlie was doing.
What was your impression of Charlie as a musician?
As a musician, he had definitely his own style, and you know, he prided himself in not playing in a set meter. You know, he wanted to be out of time. You know, and that was interesting. Being an improvisational musician, I was on a probably. Oops. Listen, I'm gonna have to call you back. That's our signal.
Okay.
And we can pick it up there. Remind me where we're talking, and I'll pick it up.
Okay.
All right, I'll dial you right back right now.
Okay.
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 You know, as far as, you know, Charlie's playing, you know, whether you like it or whether you don't like it, as with all music, it's, you know, it's sort of a subjective experience. And I kind of liked what he was doing, and at times I didn't like what he was doing, you know. As a lyricist, I thought that's where most of his talents lay. I was intrigued by his style of composing songs, and in particular in composing lyrics. I mean, things that he would make up on the spot, you know, that would just come spontaneously, were good. I mean, he was doing some good stuff, some fascinating things. And then, of course, you know, I came from a tradition, you know, my own self-developed tradition of playing improvisationally, you know, playing as nature plays, you know. That's always been my main thing, I guess, you know, my main interest.
Would you say music was an important part of life on the ranch?
Life on the ranch, you know, I don't really know that much about life on the ranch because I didn't live there.
Oh.
I used to come out and visit every so often, like a lot of people did. But yeah, I would say music had quite a lot to do with it, to what was going on there. Charlie would, you know, be, I guess, pretty much a nightly sort of thing, sometimes daytimes too, you know, gathering around and singing. Yeah, I would think that would be true. Yes, there was a lot to do with music there.
Because this is something which isn't really understood about you, isn't it? That you weren't really in the family as such at all, were you? You were sort of on the outside of it. And
I was one of a large number of people that used to come out there and visit. You know, Charlie made his inroads. He did involve himself with people involved in, you know, in the music business, as you know. I don't know whether it's hard to say because, you know, I don't know whether he really had any aspirations to market his music. I think that he did, despite the fact that he would sort of put on this show of not wanting to do that, you know, that this was like buying into the system and all that. But and by the same token, he would attract those types of people to him, and he would seek them out. So it's hard to say what was really going on there. I know that for me, to, you know, my interest in getting him into the studio and getting his songs down, you know, in some form, some coherent form, was a struggle. And all the time I knew him, you know, roughly 2.5 years or so, close to 3 years I had known him, and I would try to get him into the studio, try to, you know, get some songs down, and get frustrated with it and say, see you later, and I'd be gone again.
Yeah.
You know, that's kind of that's what our relationship was like all the time anyway.
I think you probably agree it was probably one of your less fortunate professional contacts then.
Yeah, I would say so. You know.
Yeah.
But, you know, it intrigued me that he had a lyrical style that was similar in a sense to what I was doing instrumentally, which was, you know, to play spontaneously, to be able to like, you know, create this sort of, or fall into this sort of natural flow and be able to, you know, paint symphonies on the spot, you know, that sort of thing. That had always been my interest musically, and I had been able to form relationships with like that, you know, professional relationships, artistic relationships with individuals, musicians, who could do that instrumentally. that, you know, the orchestra was that way. We had our tunes were basically frameworks in which we would improvise and play spontaneously. And, you know, each time it would be completely different. Well, playing music with Charlie was very much the same. You know, it was like that, except that he was adding that lyrical element, making it a song rather than an instrumental piece of music. And that was intriguing. You know, it was for a musician that was interested in music the way I was interested in it, that was intriguing. And it's unfortunate that more didn't come of it.
Well, I don't want to talk about all that, you know what I mean, in any detail. The only thing I would ask you,